They've given me a few minutes just to talk to all of you in our NASA family about emergency preparedness. NASA recently participated in a FEMA exercise called Eagle Horizon that was a part of a continuity of operations and government exercise that we do annually. And I became aware of some things that concern me about our family preparedness, and I wanted to talk to you very briefly. You know, we in NASA, we're an incredibly unique organization. We're the only agency in the federal government that's responsible for the safety and well-being of people not only here on Earth, but off this planet. So my experience in the astronaut office, my experience as an active duty Marine, always talked about the importance of family preparedness and to make sure that we had a viable family support program. And I have concerns that ours right now is not as good as it ought to be. So what I'm asking all of you in the NASA family, whether you're out on the West Coast, here on the East Coast, along the Gulf Coast, up on the Great Lakes, think about the natural disasters that could occur in your area. Think about attacks that could come like 9/11 from outside forces, and talk to your family about your work and what they need to do to prepare for the unforeseen. Develop a family preparedness plan in your house. Have an emergency supply kit available. Most people who live along the Gulf Coast always have an emergency kit for hurricanes. I'm not sure whether people out on the West Coast think about earthquakes and the like, but have an emergency supply kit at your home. Think about a family communications plan. Where are we going to meet if an emergency occurs and we're all over town? What are we going to do? Are we going to call each other on the cell phone? Just think about those things. If you have pets, think about a pet preparedness plan. How are you going to make sure that they're taken care of when you're spread all over the place? And then if you have family members who have special needs preparedness. The most important asset for us to successfully complete our mission is that our people, our families mainly, are taken care of so that we can come to work and feel good that if an emergency arises, our families are going to be taken care of. So I would ask you again, sit with your families, think about what you would do in an emergency situation. I hope that you'll embrace and support the Family Preparedness Program as we all get better prepared to deal with these emergencies. Know your stuff. You know what it is that you're going to do. Know what it is that you want your family to do if an emergency arises. But most of all, be prepared.